one. It is cold out here. Clearwater Beach is practically deserted. This is definitely not beach weather, but we did find a few brave souls out and about throughout the day, still trying to enjoy the water.
We have been told that the 16-year-old boy has a broken jaw and head trauma. He is being treated at St. Joseph's Hospital in Tampa. 18-year-old William Hogan is being treated at Tampa General Hospital. Police say that he was in very critical condition when he was taken from the accident scene. For the first time, we are hearing portions of an interview that Julie Scheniger did with police shortly after the deaths of her two children.
The remains of two heroes from the Bay Area who had their lives cut tragically short are now back in Florida with their loved ones.
Sergeant First Class Daniel Ferguson was laid to rest here this afternoon. His death, not from overseas combat, but a hero just the same.
The fight at the fair involved teenagers, so law enforcement and community leaders really wanted to go to the source. They invited teens to come to an NAACP meeting to give their perspective and talk about possible solutions. A woman out shopping thought it was her lucky day. A man and woman approached her in the shopping center parking lot, told her they found a wallet full of cash and that she could have a share, but it all turned out to be a scam. The Rays lease here at Tropicana Field runs through 2027. On scene in St. Petersburg, Lori Davison, Bay News 9. As for how much of a tax she'll pay, it really depends on where you live. For example, if you're in Hillsborough, Pinellas, or Pasco County, it'll be 7%, but if you're in Hernando County, it'll be 6.5%. They did take an informal, unscientific survey at the forum. Nearly 75% of the people in the room said that they would support legalizing medical marijuana, but of course, the only vote that really counts is the one coming up on November 4th. All of the dogs are currently being taken care of at Hillsborough County Pet Resources. The head of the school says that they are bringing in grief counselors to talk with students. Meanwhile, investigators say that they will be back out here again at daylight trying to sort this all out. Saturday night, the big Bollywood Awards show will be taking place here at Raymond James Stadium. But even after the show is over, if you still want a taste of Bollywood, the board did not vote on this tonight. In fact, it wasn't even on the official agenda. It came up during the public comments.
She was the gift wrapper. She was the cooker. She put up the Christmas tree.
One just wanted to die. She didn't want to be there. She would say, die.
You know, we're busy trying to put things back together and getting, you know, our roof. Part of the roof was off sanctuary.
We want them to understand why we're asking people to evacuate. And that's why we do things like videos about explaining what things are.
It sends a message that these nursing homes need to clean up their act or they shouldn't put their loved ones there. It's a sad state of affairs.
A hurricane gives us days, days of warning where you'll know it's going to be coming and you can make those preparations.
The 4-year-old boy who was shot was taken to the hospital where he was treated and released. So police say that he is going to be okay. The sheriff's office says that it had not answered any calls at this house before. Investigators are also looking into the family's financial records, their financial history, but so far that information has not been released. They are still in the process of trying to sort this whole thing out. On scene in Hillsborough County, Lori Davison, Bay News 9.